Good afternoon, class. In today's class, we are discussing. We are going to discuss this differences between the CMOS technology and the bipolar technology, right? So actually, this bipolar technology played a crucial role in the starting days of electronic devices, right? Actually, the concept of MOSFET came first. But it took many number of years for the development of the MOSFET. But meanwhile, this bipolar transistors, BJTs, these BJTs came into existence, and almost all the devices are made up of these bipolar devices, bipolar junction transistors. Okay, so actually we have some advantages of bipolar technology and disadvantages of bipolar technology. And now, after the existence of MOS technology, that means NMOSFET and PMOSFET, we combined both the NMOSFET and PMOSFET to form the CMOS technology. Okay, we have some advantages of CMOS technology, and also we have some disadvantages in CMOS technology also. That thing we can see here. So generally, we can find the differences between the CMOS technology and bipolar technology. Bipolar technology is different from BiCMOS technology. BiCMOS technology means it is the combination of both the bipolar technology and the CMOS technology. Okay, what you are able to understand now, CMOS technology is having some advantages and disadvantages, and bipolar technology is having some advantages and disadvantages. To overcome the disadvantages present in the both, we combined the both and we enjoyed the both the advantages present in the both CMOS technology and the bipolar technology. Okay, that is the thing in the BiCMOS technology. Okay, so first we see the differences between the CMOS technology and the bipolar technology. First we see here in the CMOS technology. CMOS technology is nothing but the combination of NMOSFET and the PMOSFET. We have both NMOSFET and the PMOSFET. We combined both the NMOSFET and PMOSFET to form the CMOS technology. Okay, the base level minimum connection in the CMOS technology is the inverter, right? We require one NMOS transistor and PMOS transistor to form an inverter in the CMOS technology. So you see here in the CMOS technology, we have low static power dissipation. Okay, low static power dissipation, and the bipolar technology you can see here, high power dissipation. First, you have to see what is this concept called dissipation and consumption. Okay, consumption means you are making use of that particular thing. Okay, dissipation means here you are unnecessarily wasting some amount of power. You understand? Consumption means you are consuming some amount of power. For example, if you are able to eat only one plate of rice, one plate of meals, okay, if I provide you two plates of meals, what you will do? You will waste that extra plate of meals. Okay, that means you are dissipating one plate of meals. That means you are wasting one plate of meals. Do you understand now? Low static power dissipation. Okay, that means you are able to consume only one plate of meals and you are dissipating one plate of meals. That means you are wasting. Okay, so in this same format, you can see in the CMOS technology, we have low static power dissipation. Okay, that means low means it's a advantage, right? Low static power dissipation. That means you are wasting very less amount of power. The static power. We have two types of powers generally, static power and the dynamic power. So the thing we can understand in detail in the later classes. First, you can understand what is this static, the concept of this power dissipation. can see here, in the CMOS technology, we have low static power dissipation. That means it is an advantage, right? In the bipolar technology, we have high power dissipation. We have more amount of power being wasted in the bipolar technology. So it is a disadvantage for the bipolar technology, right? So we have, in the CMOS technology, can see we have high input impedance. If we have high input impedance, it is a disadvantage for us. Okay, we can see in the braces, high input impedance leads to the low drive current. So the current driving capability will be less. If you have high input impedance, the current driving capability will be low. It's a disadvantage in the CMOS technology. But in the bipolar technology, you can see here, we have low input impedance. So automatically, we are going to have high drive current. Okay. Okay. So it becomes an advantage in the bipolar technology. Okay. But we have an advantage in the CMOS technology, but only in the CMOS technology, that is scalable threshold voltage. Scalable threshold voltage. What does this mean? You have seen the operation of MOS transistor. That is, generally we have seen the NMOSFET transistor operation in the enhancement mode, and that you can see here, the threshold voltage is nothing but we started giving some amount of input voltage. After that, we keep on increasing the input voltage, generally starting from 0 volts, we are giving the positive voltage in the format of 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, like that. So after reaching the threshold voltage only, the transistor started responding, right? After that, it worked in some linear region and later it went to the saturation region. Okay, what does this mean now? Here, the scalable threshold voltage means we can reduce the threshold voltage in the CMOS technology, but in the bipolar technology, we don't have such type of concept. Okay. So generally, the CMOS technology is very, very advantageous. Why? Because we can form our own functions, highly complex. That means where we require more number of transistors, we will be using the CMOS technology. Okay. Within the less amount of area, we can accumulate more number of transistors. Okay. And when we are trying to reduce the size of the transistor, we need to reduce the threshold voltage also. Okay. That's the concept of the CMOS technology, which will be very much helpful. Okay, scalable threshold voltage. Okay, it is present in the CMOS technology only. It is not present in the bipolar technology. In the CMOS technology, we can see here the fourth point. You can see high noise margin. Okay, this CMOS technology is having high noise margin. And in the bipolar technology, we have very low voltage swing logic. High noise margin is an advantage in the CMOS technology. Low voltage swing logic, it's a disadvantage in the bipolar technology. What is this high noise margin? So that means we generally have some amount of noise. Okay, we used to have some amount of noise. Even though that noise is a little bit more, this CMOS technology can be operated there. So it obeys this way, even though we have high amount of noise, right? You can see here, low voltage swing logic, you can see it won't allow huge amount of swing in the logic. Okay, bipolar technology. You can see one more advantage in the CMOS technology, that is high packing density and low packing density. I used to say that in the CMOS technology, I can accumulate more number of transistors on the single silicon wafer die. Okay. So one square unit of single silicon wafer die is taken. In that, if I use CMOS technology, I can accumulate more number of transistors. But whereas in the bipolar junction transistor, I can't accumulate more number of transistors if I use bipolar transistors. Okay. That is called as low packing density. Packing density here in the sense, accumulating more number of transistors on the single silicon wafer die. Right. High delay sensitive to load. High delay sensitivity to load. Low delay sensitivity to load. So you can see high delay sensitivity to load means, is it an advantage or disadvantage? So generally sensitivity should be less for us. Okay. Sensitivity should be less. So in the CMOS technology, we are having high delay sensitivity to the load. It is becoming a fan out limitations. In the braces, you can see here, it is a fan out limitation. But in the bipolar technology, you can see here, low delay sensitivity to load. Low delay sensitivity to load is an advantage in the bipolar technology. Okay. Since if the load is increased, we will be having more delay in the CMOS technology, right? So fan in, fan out, we have this concept. Fan in, fan out means the number of inputs connected to a gate is nothing but fan in, and the number of, if an output is driving other gates, the number of gates it is going to drive is known as fan out. You understand? Fan in means, for a gate, the number of inputs connected is called as a fan in, and fan out is nothing but that particular gate's output is connected to many number of gates as in inputs, maybe. So that is fan out. At the output side, it is connected to the same output is connected to many number of gates as an input, or that has to drive other circuits. That is called as fan out. Okay. Low output drive current. In the CMOS technology, we have low output drive current. So in the bipolar technology, we have high output drive current. We should have high output drive current. It is an advantage in the bipolar technology, but in the CMOS technology, we have very low output drive current. Okay. Next. So this GM, you can see it is related to the conductance. Okay, conductance. We have low GM, which is generally proportional to the input voltage. But in the bipolar technology, we have high GM, high conductance, which is exponentially proportional to the Vin, input voltage. Okay, high GM and we have low GM. High conductance is a good sign for us, right? High GM is a good sign, which is in the bipolar technology, right? So operating frequency, you can see here, high FT at low currents. Even though we have at the low currents, we have this timing frequencies. Okay, high, they will be high. This, we don't have such type of concept in the CMOS technology. High FT at low currents is also an advantage in the bipolar technology. Okay, we have a separate identical advantage in the CMOS technology, that is bidirectional capability. Okay, what is this? Bidirectional capability means, in the MOS transistor, I have sources and the drains, both the source and the drain, both. For example, if I am taking an NMOS FET, in an NMOS FET, the source and drain both will be of N plus only. That means highly concentrated N. Okay, I can interchange my source and the drain. I can change its direction. Sources and the drains can be interchanged. Okay, I can treat source on the left side and the drain on the right side, or else I can change it to the drain on the left side and the source on the right side. I can do like that in the CMOS technology. But bipolar technology, you can see here, it should be essentially unidirectional. It should be essentially unidirectional. Just see, remember, you know, just remember who the bipolar junction transistor is. Okay, this to have emitter, in that we have a base, that we used to have a collector. This is the structure of bipolar junction transistor. Remember, right? Interface. So this is the emitter, right? You can see. So this is the emitter, this is the base, and this is the collector. So one region is present in the another one. So we don't have the capability of this bidirectional capability. Okay. For a bipolar device or bipolar junction transistor. But you can see the MOSFET where we can have like this source and the drains. Source and the drain. This can be treated as source one time, and this can be treated as drain. And this can be treated as drain, and this can be treated as source. That means I can interchange. And also this this MOSFET, that means CMOS technology, we can have near ideal switching device. Okay, we can also have ideal switching device. This MOS technology means we are using a transistor. There we can make it as ideal switching device. Okay. Just the help of some other diagrams, I am explaining you once again the NVL process and all. Once again, just you can see, just something in color format. Okay, so it is the p-type of substrate, and I am going for oxidation. This is an NVL process. I am just explaining once again. Okay, NMOS fabrication. Sorry. So you see here we have p-type substrate. For that, this is a NMOS fabrication process, right? NMOS fabrication process. So we have a p-type substrate. For that, we have an oxidation process is done. So oxidation process is done there. Okay, see here. In the green color, you can see the photoresist material. For the photoresist material, see, actually it is CMOS in the NVL process. Okay, CMOS in the NVL process. You see here now. We are using a mask here. So this is the mask. The dotted line you can see. And this is the blocking area of the mask, and the arrow mark UV UV rays. Okay, so the part which unexposed part of UV light will be gel type and it will be removed. Okay, and we have to remove that silicon dioxide by using acid etching, and after that we will be removing the photoresist material. After that we are forming the n-type of well. Okay, after that totally I am going to some hydrofluoric acid we are using for the removal of silicon dioxide. Actually it is not necessary to remove this silicon dioxide. We will be adding one more silicon dioxide and will be forming actually. So thin silicon dioxide is once again thin, you can see here thin gate oxide, that is thin silicon dioxide is poured, and after that over that we are going to form the polysilicon. We are pouring the polysilicon. Okay, this polysilicon and in the N-well process you can form the other transistors. Okay, you see here we formed a N-well in the P-type substrate. We have formed a N-well. This is the silicon, thin silicon dioxide, and the red color you can see here it has gate material. This is the gate material. Okay, so in the N-well you are going to form here P-type of transistor. Okay, the P substrate we will form transistor here. Okay, this is oxide stripping and all. I will share this content once again. You can go through it. Okay. So N plus, this is NMOS transistor, it's a P substrate in N well. Here you are observing N plus here. This N plus is to connect this substrate to the outer world only. Okay, here we have a P plus, and we are forming a P plus for this NMOS, the PMOS transistor. Here also we are forming one P plus. Why? Because we want to connect this P type of substrate. Substrates will be lightly doped. So when we are connecting, making some connection at the connecting point itself, we should have a little bit higher concentration. That's the reason why we are forming a P plus here and N plus here. Okay. Thick field oxide is also formed. Thick field oxide means it is in the range of 1 millimeter in thickness. Okay. So that thick oxide is also formed, and we can form removal of excess metal. Okay, that will be so thick field oxide is poured, that means yellow color one is poured. After that we are going for metallization. Aluminum is sputtered on the whole wafer, which will be used as some connecting wire generally what we use. After that we will be removing the excess metal. Like this, excess metal will be removed. Generally, sometimes we used to remove, and sometimes we don't remove. We have to observe that whether that particular region is connected to the outer world or not. Okay, with the help of metal. Okay, this P plus is connected with this one. This you can see here. This one, this source you can see is connected with this blue color one. So this gate material is connected with the help of from here, and the drain is connected from here. Okay, you can see here we are connecting the terminals. So blue thing you can see here, that blue material you can see there, it is going to connect to the outer world, NMOS and PMOS. Here we have formed, that is using N-well process. CMOS fabrication N-well process. And the application of P-well process is similar, just changes. We can identify the changes. Okay, and the twinter process is just like this. We have n-type substrate, and over that we form an epitoxy layer. Ep means upside, epitoxy layer. In that epitoxy layer, we'll be forming both the N-well and the P-well. Okay. Okay, in today's class, we have discussed regarding the differences between the CMOS technology and the bipolar technology. We have find what are the advantages in the CMOS technology and disadvantages also. And the bipolar technologies, we have seen advantages and disadvantages. After that, we have gone with the revision of the fabrication process of CMOS, CMOS twin tap process using N-well and P-well. And the pin tap can be also be explained from the figures, right?